crazy if they are. But then it's a complete waste of money. Because when the people give you it, the door is closed. The plan comes to $100,000 a year worth of investment. I worked out those for my analytics.
I printed it out, so the email copies will be available here. It is the district marketing plan, and I have to say, congratulations to the team that produced this plan. It is a very, very good document. It embodies everything that we should be doing to market this district. It is, you know, hard to fault in many ways. Should make some notes here so I can get them in the right order, it'll save a lot of time. One thing I found really interesting in this plan is that the word online is mentioned 35 times in an 18-page document. And that social media is mentioned, and that there's references to things like Facebook and LinkedIn. I find that interesting because when the CEO first started his role here at the council, I invited him to my studio and workshop, and I suggested to him that perhaps the council could use my YouTube channels to promote the district. He said he didn't believe social media was important. I'm pretty sure he's probably changed his perspective now. And this plan, hopefully you'll get it past the CEO because it is a great piece of work. And if the plan is implemented, I can see a lot of people coming to the council's doors because there are some really, really good things. There is collaboration with stakeholders through the joint promotion of the district. And the objectives are good too. They want to attract new people to the district. We need new people. They want to attract new businesses. We need new businesses. And they want to attract visitors. We can all benefit from visitors. That's why, partly why we're doing the Lead Place redevelopment. Great objectives. Fantastic. The mechanisms in this thing are great too. They want local businesses who have national and international networks to be advocating for the district as a great place to do business. They want us to, they also reflect on tourism. They want people to recommend the town to their friends and their colleagues and things overseas. So this networking thing is a great thing. Word of mouth is one of the biggest ways you can market something. Interestingly enough, actually everything in this district marketing plan is stuff that I've been doing for the last 7 or 8 years to promote this district myself. As a result, a lot of businesses have come to Tangaroa and looked at things, particularly the airfield, and none of them have set up shop yet. A lot of tourists come from around the world, get them on the guest book here, and it has entries from Hungary, Yugoslavia, every country in the world just about represented in my guest book. People have come to Tangaroa solely as a result of my networking through the facilities I have available, my YouTube channels, for example. And I think you all know my YouTube channels are very successful. I'm getting a collection of these, which are silver play buttons, which are only awarded to YouTube channels that have reached certain standards and certain things. So YouTube acknowledge. I have a letter from the CEO of YouTube here thanking me and acknowledging the performance of my YouTube channel. So I have a powerful tool to network and reach people all around the world. I get 1 million views a month on my YouTube channels. And that works out at about, I think I checked for January, if you took the combined viewing time of all my videos during the month of January, it came to nearly 10 years. So I have a powerful tool. Now, this marketing plan says we need to harness people in the community, their passion, their enthusiasm, their knowledge, their skills. Excuse me. I've been doing this for 7 or 8 years. But we're building this wonderful path, and this marketing plan will do it, building a fantastic path to the door of the South Waikato, which will remain firmly closed if my experiences are anything to go by. One of the world's largest aerospace systems tried to establish a dialogue with the council, and the CEO said he was too busy to call back. We've had companies involved in the unmanned aviation industry come to Tokyo and look at the options, and then go away and spend their money elsewhere, because the council is intransigent. They don't realise that if you want to attract these businesses, you've also got to be flexible and make changes to accommodate them. It's not a take or leave situation. As it says there, the market is competitive. Other districts are also seeking exactly these objectives. We need a point of distinction. We've got a huge advantage. We've got me and my ability to get a message out to lots of people. Already hundreds of people come every year to visit Tokoroa because of me, but they don't stay. Because there's no reason the council is not flexible enough to say, hey, if we did this, these people would stay. I'm frustrated. I think this plan's great, but the plan will be let down. The plan is a complete waste of money. Because when the people get here, the door is closed. The plan comes to $100,000 a year worth of investment. I worked out, I looked at my analytics.
Mr. Simpson, 5 minutes. comments. So okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate that. Thank you. Elected members, councillors, are there any questions, any comments?
I would make one comment to Mr. Simpson, my brother, just before. When he tells little stories about our CEO not contacting a major firm to try to make contact with him, that's untrue. He made contact with him and they said, yes, we are watching Mr. Simpson with interest, and when he has something that is good for us, we may come back to you. Just a point of clarification.
Well, that's not what the CEO told me, so...
Thank you. We now have Mr. Rod Young, if you would like to come forward. Thank you, Mr. Simpson.
What does the bell mean?
It means that 5 minutes is up.
Yeah.
All right, your time starts now.
Thanks. This is their latest in touch. This is what I read this morning over breakfast. Councillor Bell had written in here, and also Councillor Jeff Gass had written in the 10-year plan. I was one of six people that went across the road to the event centre when the 14,000 of Tokoroa were invited to come over and submit. I actually left the meeting because of the way that it was being run with regards to wanting to give ideas to that. So I'm going to take this 5 minutes now of the stuff that I wasn't able to say at that meeting just to share with you here. Councillor Bell brought up an interesting point about the... to remember that people spend more per month on electricity than on rates, and you get a lot more for your rates dollars. That's one of the greatest assets we have in this district. Waikato River, of the nine rivers, dams, five of them are in the South Waikato, and I wanted to raise issues. One of the big things about public health is that we've got a smog problem, one of the 23 inversion layers in New Zealand, and if we offset burning wheat firewood in our district, in Tokoroa and in Pitaru, then we can actually have much better health for the community, and the regional council will like that. So electricity is one of the major things that we have going for us. We also have what's called a cogen plant out at the mill where they burn the old wooden stuff, and that generates electricity. And we've also got some geothermal down at Aotearoa that can be developed for the community. And even if it's just for the community to offset the costs of heating so that we get a better environment. And if we're going to have a regional tax, when I go to Auckland or the airport and I fill up my car, I have to pay 10 cents a litre on that, and that all goes to Auckland for their infrastructure. Well, I'm suggesting to you that you have an asset here, which is the dams, and 1 cent per kilowatt, which comes back to develop South Waikato, which the million people in Auckland pay, and they get the benefit when they come down here into our walkways and stuff. So there are some big picture things that we have in our district plan that we need to consider. My criticism of what happened across the road, there was one person in the meeting who wanted to hear what the council had to say, and there were five other people that wanted to contribute with new ideas and that sort of thing. Mr. Simpson was one of them, who wanted to contribute some new stuff. I wanted to contribute some new stuff. And it was closed down because all that the council wanted to do was present what they had to the community. And you know, there's other ways of doing that, hosting it out to the 13,000 people. But when we come across the road, six of us, to actually talk with council, we want to have that engagement process, because we're already engaged and we already understand those things. So that's a criticism that I wanted to address for the 10-year plan. So next time we go through the annual planning process, when you do call a meeting and you ask for the community to give you ideas, it's a blank sheet of paper. It's not telling us what. It's about our community sharing those big strategic, not the management stuff, and a lot of this was about how the management of council works. And as a person who's looking at governance and talking to governance here, I'm looking at those big picture, those 50, 150 years. So one of them is electricity. So I'd like to say to you today to firmly put that on your agenda or strategic and lever it. And I can hear the squeals from Auckland when we put 1 cent a kilowatt to develop our district. But that's one of the leverages that we do have. And I think that we need to use that to our advantage. So that's what I wanted to say today to this meeting. So, and as I said, it's important that I use Councillor Gash and Adrian Bell's information, because that's the best way. public forum, reads these, and then shares on it.
Thank you, Mr. Yeah. Are there any comments? Councillor Shorter, then Councillor Glusek.
You see, I remember, you know, we were going through the public consultation with the... now, I've personally been to eight of those meetings.
Yeah.
And people express their views freely, and I think that, you know, the council staff has taken that into account, and they, yeah, so I can't see, I really cannot see your point in saying that, you know, a council would tell what was going to happen instead of consulting. So that's my point.
Thank you, Mr. Councillor Shorter. Councillor
Christina. Just to clarify, the electricity to the dams, the only power the council has got to extract money from the dams is rates. We did take rates off the dam. We were challenged because we were asking for too much and had to reduce it. We got no power to levy the electricity being produced at all. If you go and want to lobby central government and give us that power, that would be great, but we haven't got the power, so we can't do it.
Thank you. Any other questions? Thank you, Mr. Young. We now have Mr. Bridle.